Good evening and welcome to the Sopka Cluster. We are at Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiad. It's another romantic, magical evening underneath the lights of the Sopka Cluster, where we have the finals coming your way of the Dual Moguls, an event that's going to be fast and furious. Two racers will compete down a red and a blue course filled with mogul bumps. The ladies dual moguls eighth final will go first, followed by the men's eighth finals. The competition where it's not the first racer down the course that wins. Based on turns, that's 60% of the judges' score, air and speed. Ladies dual moguls, as previously mentioned, will come first, the men's second, where we have all of our medalists from the moguls here last night. It was dramatic, exciting stuff and great skiing from our racers. But this is different. You're competing. The one who scores the highest goes through. The one who scores the lowest goes home. Simple. Wonderful shots of Siberia. It has been overcast all day, but really under the lights, the visibility is just perfect. The piece, faultless. As the riders prepare for their final competition of these games, it's been a games where Russia have broken the record for gold medals won. 34. So we look at the course length, almost 240 meters. Racers will have to stay facing down the fall line, the quickest possible route to the end, staying in control with speed, but skiing quick enough to still get marked high. Control is key. Seven judges. Average score counts. Quarterfinals have finished in the qualifications for the semis. Horishima against Hara. It's all Japan in one semi. And Kavei against Pavel Kolmakov in the other. So we head towards the women's semi-finals. Leah Biard up against Elizaveta Bezgodova, coming our way first. Number one qualifier, Leah Biard, looked assured in the previous run. Elizaveta Bezgodova has won on the Russian circuit for dual moguls, but hasn't raced outside Russia since 2017. A seventh at the World Junior Championships. But Leah Biard, second last night, is looking for gold this evening. Both racers off to a ferocious start, where the Russian on the left of your screen has started slightly quicker, but the rhythm from the German on the right is slightly better. Therefore, she's gone in front throughout the mid section of the course. Everything's looking down the hill. Everything's in rhythm, everything's intact, and the air's good from Leah Biard, and she should go through to the final. Couple of errors, it's hard to come back. One misplaced turn could be good night and curtains for your entire event. goes through. Leah Biard, first name in the final from Germany. Top of qualifying, flying again. Last night's winner, the gold medalist, Kisara Sumiyoshi. Skiing the blue course up against Antonina Dyatkina from Russia, who didn't ski yesterday, but is in great form here this evening. So quick out the gates is a Japanese 19-year-old from Nihon University. A little bit skinny on the top section, but now she starts to find the fall line, the more direct route down the hill. The poles are soft. The pole plants are very delicate, and there's no space in the legs, but Dyatkina's gone. Too much space, too much rotation in the legs and the upper body. Cruise control has been set for Sumiyoshi, and the top two from last night will be top two again here this evening. Leah Biard already in the final. Elizaveta Bezgonova will go to the small final. And you'd think that the second finalist, Kisara Sumiyoshi, will go through. Antonina Dyatkina will go through to the small final. Confirmation coming through. She's going for two golds in two evenings, Kisara Sumiyoshi. Men's semi-final of the dual moguls. Kumi Horishima up against Dashihara first. That's second against third yesterday. Dashihara skiing on the red course, took the silver. Kumi Horishima took the bronze yesterday. There's always a friendly rivalry between these two. Two of the best on the world circuit now go head to head, toe to toe on this bumpy road. Huge first airs. Horishima, who's skied faultlessly all evening, but he's found his match against Dashihara, who's currently a little bit slower. But faultless skiing by both so far. Huge second airs as well. Horishima goes on the line. That might just open the door for Dashihara. Although, was it too late? The land of the rising sun. Have two great mogul skiers. Huge shapes. Both going off axes. Dashihara, Okuma, Horishima for a place in the big final. Searching for the grab, and he got it, didn't he, Dashihara? The Maksumi with a cross from Horishima. Japan, only one can qualify for the big final. It's taking time. Falling over the finish line. Who takes it? Akuma Horishima goes through to the big final. Dashihara will be going for bronze. Benjamin Covey knows all about winning gold medals here, having won last night. Pavel Kolmakov has skied relentlessly to be here against last night's main man. But this is going to be a challenge. Covey loves getting out the gates very quick. They both go off axes twice. On the first air, Covey's gone! And Benjamin Covey will not be winning two golds in two evenings. It looks as if it's Kazakhstan. We'll have a finalist, the Maksumi with a cross. Pavel Kolmakov will be going through. Consistency pays off for Kazakhstan. That's going to hurt Covey, who's been aggressive. He's skied so, so well. But one error of judgment. Costly. Kazakhstan, no. Covey showing off to the crowd. He will have a very tough battle for bronze against Dashihara.
Yes, indeed,
Pavel Kolmakov goes through to the big final.
Yeah.
Benjamin Covey to the small. We get ready for the ladies' dual moguls small final. Elizaveta Bezgodova against Antonina Byatkina. It's an all-Russian small final. Bezgodova goes in blue. Byatkina goes on the red side. Concentration and focus. The winner walks away with Winter Universiade bronze. Control and consistency imperative, but speed and good in the air has to be there as well. There's a couple of really small errors from both, but Daikina, the separation in the legs just a moment ago, and there it is again. Consistency isn't quite there from Antonina Daikina. She's slightly quicker as we reach the second air though. Both go with back summies. It's going to be close over the finish line. 0.05 of a second, but that's 20% of the grade from the judges. Big hugs. There's Godova just landing a little bit separated there. Some nice shots of the knees staying quite close together. Lots of rotation in the heels. We have been treated. To a fantastic display of moguls. But who takes bronze? Bezgodova from Russia. Congratulations, bronze medalist at the Winter Universiade 2019. The ladies' dual moguls big final. The two top skiers from yesterday now go head to head. Sara Sumiyoshi on the blue course after winning gold yesterday. Qualified in third place, Leah Boyard on the red course. Sumiyoshi on the left of your screen, Leah Boyard on the right. The winner takes the gold. It's not the first one to the bottom. It's whoever impresses the judges the most. Boyard skiing with so much confidence, but there's class as well from Sumiyoshi, but she's almost gone over the inside ski, and now she's playing catch-up. One would think that Leah Boyard just has to stay controlled here, and Sumiyoshi has gone. Second time of asking, the German Leah Boyard, the 22-year-old from the University of Mont Blanc, has skied so well over the previous 2 days, and now she takes gold. Commiserations to Kisara Sumiyoshi. She has to settle for silver this evening. Both skiers leave with one gold and one silver from this games. Getting all caught up. Sumiyoshi. Consistency from Boyard. The back summy with the cross and a good landing to go with it. The gold medalist, Leah Bouillard. Congratulations to Germany. And also, Kisara Sumiyoshi, she takes the silver. There's the podium. Krasnoyarsk 2019. The top four, actually, there can only be one winner. And you can see it's Leah Bouillard with a big smile on her face. Some competition, this one. Sopka Cluster keeps delivering. Men dual moguls, small final. It's for bronze, but it could easily be for gold. First, the second from yesterday's competition. Racing. Benjamin Kobe from France on the blue. Dashihara from Japan, racing red. Kove on the left of your screen from France, Dashihara on the right from Japan, two of the world's best skiers. Go head to head for bronze. Kove is aggressive, as we've seen all over the previous 2 days. He goes for speed, everything looking down the hill once again. He's dynamic on the dance floor, he's so enthusiastic, but Dashihara's completely with him here. This contest has a bit of everything. The airs are great as well. What a level of skiing. They should both win medals. Such good changes of direction. Really smooth. Both so good in the air. The landings, very strong as well. Only one winner though, and where's the bronze medal going to go? Benjamin Kove just by a whisker. Two medals in 2 days for Benjamin Kove. Congratulations to both racers though. Incredible level. Final race of the evening, the men dual moguls big final, Japan versus Kazakhstan. Akuma Horishima from Japan racing blue, Pavel Kolmakov racing on the red course in this final. Horishima, 21 from Chukyo University, Kolmakov from Almaty University. Only one can win gold. They've both skied incredibly well to be here, and it's such a rapid start. Horishima is the quickest, but there can be no mistakes. It's a blistering pace, both looking down the fall line. Horishima is skiing so well here. Soft with the hands, really bouncy with the knees as well. The second air, Horishima goes huge. And Horishima crosses the finish line, and it looks as if he might have just taken the gold medal here from Krasnoyarsk. And even Kolmakov says, you're so fast. Pavel Kolmakov can be so proud of his efforts, but we're just waiting on the judges. Akuma Horishima has been faultless all evening. On the right side or on the left side, red or blue gates. Always looking down the four line. Sorrel big in the air. The back summy with the cross. The landing not quite perfect, but it was a sublime ski overall. Kolmakov, seventh at the Winter Games in Korea. But the gold medalist, Akuma Horoshima from Japan. Silver, Pavel Kolmakov from Kazakhstan. What an evening's race. The podium make their way into the finish area. And over the past two evenings, the moguls and the dual moguls have produced the goods here. Akuma Horoshima is the champion. Also has three World Cup wins to his name, famously the world champion in Sierra Nevada in 2017. He now has the dual moguls to go with it as we have a look at some highlights of another memorable evening. Of the ladies dual moguls medalists for this evening one last time. It's been a wonderful night here at the soccer cluster. The men's medalist confirmed for one last time, and that means from us it's goodbye from Krasnoyarsk 2019.